Yo, what's up, Blackest fam? I hope all is well in your corner of the world. Man, I got a notification that Conway the Machine put out some new music, something called Stressed, featuring Wallo 267. I'm really torn with Griselda, Conway the Machine. I like the music because it reminds me of old school hip hop. But I don't always vibe with the type of music they put out. And that's probably just my age and personal preference, but you can't deny their musical ability. So I definitely like his wordplay, his flow, the beat selections typically. So they're really excited to check this one out. But even though they're not really the type of artist that would be main playlist for me, I'd like their work, I'd listen to it, but it's not something that I would keep returning to like I might do with a Black Thought or a Nas or a J. Cole. But that's me, right? Everyone has their own preference. And, you know, I'm almost a 40-year-old middle-class dad, right, in suburbia. So I don't necessarily relate to things the same way as if I would have stayed in Chicago my entire life. So, but yo, let's check it out. This is Conway the Machine. This is Stress. What do you say? Your own, you're not as much as your accord. Yeah, I did hear he was in, got shot a bunch of times.
Three shots couldn't drop me. I took a smile, nigga.
Looking like Kanye through the wire and shit.
Got hit twice in the neck. Grazed in the head.
Damn.
You know, that's what it is, nigga.
Better do some shit.
The music still is dropping. The music still coming, nigga.
It kind of looks like, kind of looked like the building they used for Father Figure with Toby Wigway, Royce da 5'9", and Black Thought. I'll have to pull that up and check. It could be the same building, right? Right where Black, is it Toby? Toby Wigway, I think, originally is standing in the middle, and then they each take turns there. I'd have to, now I believe it's Father Figure. Father Figure. Royce, there we go. It's technically by no, it's slightly different, but man, really similar. Look at, if I can pull it over here, I don't know if you guys can see that, but similar style, but not the same building. Let's run it back and listen to this.
That's what it is, nigga. The music still is dropping. The music still coming, nigga.
Life is about trials and tribulations and overcoming obstacles, but I'm tired of shit I'm facing, cause it's not only mine, got everybody's situations that I gotta make better, and that shit take cheddar,
that shit call,
I guess everybody yeah, needs to save.
He's saying it's not about the money, but I got shit to do that takes money to get through this shit, right? He said life is about trials and tribulations, right? The ups and downs, overcoming obstacles, but goddamn, our motherfuckers facing the same shit I am, right? I'm getting shot in the neck and dome. Now he said it's not only mine, but everybody's situations that I gotta make better, and that shit take cheddar, right? Now you might have all that, man, it's not about the money, I don't do this for the money, but yo, let's be honest, money is the tool that enables you to have freedom, have to do the things that you want with the ones that you love. Without money, a lot of it wouldn't be possible, right? Let's get back to it.
I guess niggas think 10 million was Shady paid him. I tell them no, they talk down.
Okay, he said was Shady paid him. I think he was assigned at one point to Shady Records, right? Or Griselda was signed to Shady Records, if I'm not mistaken.
I guess niggas think 10 million was Shady paid him. I tell them no, they talk down on me and try to play it. Guess they forgot about all the other shit that I gave them.
About all the other times.
Funny how they can be so forgetful.
Motherfuckers always are.
I'm sure this is something every real nigga worldwide can attest to. When a nigga needs something, the only time you call a check, that's all.
Do niggas ever think for real, right? I had a buddy once that this cat was locked up. Old school friend, right? Homie from back in the day, like school bus together. And his sister hit me up and was like, yo, he's locked up, right? $20,000 D-bond. I'm like, I'll bet it's only $2,000. I could swing it, even though I was only maybe 17 at the time. Well, what happens? I call his girl up because I can't bond him out myself. I'm not an adult. And she comes with some dude who's old enough to bond him out. And I'm just like, who the fuck is dude, right? But it's my boy, so I'm not asking questions. Well, we bond him out, and while we're waiting for him to be released from county, it's just taking hours, right? I'm like, man, I think there's a restaurant right up the way here in Chicago. I take everybody out. I had a little dough, right? I took everybody out to some Italian restaurant, and we just have fun, shoot the shit, come back, and people are like, yo, it could legit take hours. So I end up going back to the crib. My buddy gets out, and when I get that late night call, and I'm like, oh shit, I'm like, yo, what's up, man? He said, bro, why'd you take my girl out? Motherfucker, what? Why don't you tripping on the road? You should be thanking me for bonding your ass out, you know, with your little 5'6" ass. But yo, the bigger question is, why did your girl pull up with some other dude, right? Why don't you question dude she was with and not your homeboy that's bonding you out, right? People are so quick you're reacting too quick. Why don't you take a second to look at the bigger picture? But that kind of relates to this. So he said, well, motherfuckers need something is the only time they call and check. But also when you help people out, they don't ever remember it, right? They remember the little parts that are relevant to them. But it's like, yo, if I weren't here, your ass would be sitting in motherfucking Division II somewhere, fighting off dudes, trying to prove you're a neutron. At least you could do it at the crib and wait for a trial, right? Wait for your court date. and man, that homie ended up was one of my boys, but he got that money back. You know, they take 10%, so he got $1,800 back. Didn't even give it to me. Old boy bought a car. I should have beat his motherfucking ass, but he was my boy, right? So I let it slide. But you know, you never forget that. It's like, I know it might have cost me $1,800, but I know not to fuck with you like that. And it sucks because people will do you dirty like that. Even though it's like, yo, at 17 years old, there's a lot better things that I could choose to spend $2,000 on. Outside of you, motherfucker, right? I would give me some fly shit, give me a tight bitch, go travel or some shit. You know, I could do any number of things besides fucking with your ass and your shady ass girlfriend.
You need something the only time you call and check. That's all facts. Do niggas ever think that I'm stressed too? Niggas act like I owe them. That shit is stressful. My girl said don't let it stress you, but she don't even know that I'm depressed too. Do anybody care that I'm stressed? I'm stressed too, homie. Most of my homies died.
Yeah, motherfuckers, they think just because you're a G, right? Just because you've seen some shit in your day that you don't stress out. It's like, yeah, we might stress out, but we show it in a different way, right? We might sit back and blow some green. You know, some people are aggressive towards other people, their family. People handle stress differently, right? Now, like they say, police officers have one of the highest spousal abuse reports in the nation, right? Why is that? Why is it that they're more prone to suicide, right? They see things that they can't handle, right? Or they're taking out on their loved ones because they're stressed from their jobs, right?
Had the rest of them doing time, and do anybody care that I'm stressed? I'm going to do it. I don't come around, so I guess it's out of sight, out of mind. But
I could have really seen something like what Joyner Lucas did, or what Marlon Craft did with Gang Shit, or Joyner Lucas with I'm Not Racist. He could have called this stress. But shown his perspective, being stressed as someone that's trying to make moves and shit's coming out the woodworks and fucking with him, and then a cop being stressed because he's just trying to get home safe to his family, that would have been a really good play and showed both perspectives as to why both people are stressed and why things might escalate much quicker in the streets, right? I would have loved to have seen that.
Do anybody care that I'm stressed?
Do niggas care?
Everybody got their hand out asking me for shit, but do anybody care that I'm stressed?
Niggas don't know what I'm going
do
through,
anybody
man.
Care?
Y'all niggas give a fuck
care
what I'm doing?
Bullshit in life, everybody go through that. But it's a lesson in it all, you gotta grow through that.
Uh-huh.
I was down bad and broke, but I wrote through that. Thought my problems would go away if I could blow through rap. Dutch master smoked a whole 2 packs.
Smoke.
This kind of stress, I wouldn't want my worst enemy to go through that. My cousin, he took a cord and put his throat through that.
He pulled that Jussie Smollett, right? Yeah, always, anytime I hear a noose, I don't give a fuck. That's Jussie Smollett. Oh, fuck up my career with, what'd he say? Motherfuckers at 2 a.m. outside the subway just happened to have a noose on him and just happened to see Jussie Smollett and put two and two together. Like, yo, we gonna get this dude. Like, man, get your lying ass out of here. Oh, fake ass.
Me to go through that. My cousin, he took a cord and put his throat
chance to tell a nigga, don't do that.
Niggas don't understand depression is real.
Yeah.
Stressing about real life shit. You stressing your
business. Not too long. Nah. Dudes be stressing all sorts of shit, right? Motherfuckers ain't got a hairline no more. Motherfuckers are ugly. Your motherfucking girl's a hoe, right? Your kids are stupid. All sorts of shit. It's like, motherfucker, that ain't real stress. You're dealing with everyday life shit. We all got that. But you know, it could get a lot worse, right? Getting a lot worse is a bottomless pit, bro.
People stressing about real life shit. You stressing.
There's motherfuckers out here that are legit only a torso. Right, you know, they gotta get taken care of every inch of the day, right? There's motherfuckers out here pissing and shitting in bags. Motherfuckers out here that can't use their legs, right? Can't use their words. You know, I had a cousin that was not just mentally retarded. This motherfucker was deaf, ended up being blind through the diabetes. So he was, you know, imagine being deaf, blind, and mentally not there. It's like, do you even know what the fuck is going on? Do you even understand that this is specific to you? Right? It's just, man, fucked up.
Your bills. That ain't not too long after my cousin hung himself. I never told nobody, but I lost a son myself.
Damn.
Imagine being in the hospital holding your dead baby. And he looked just like you. You're trying to keep from going crazy.
That's my world.
That's why I drink a bottle daily for
damn.
All the shit I keep bottled in lately. Do anybody care that I'm stressed?
I'm stressed.
Yo, stress is real, and I just have to say and take a second to realize, man, there's no shame in seeing a mental health professional and discussing your feelings, right? A lot of people think they're too G for that, right? Nah, man, I'm from the hood. We don't do that in the streets, right? All right, bro, that shit bottled up, and you end up beating your wife or doing some stupid-ass shit out there. And, you know, a lot of it you can avoid by just having a conversation about it, getting it out, right?
So most of my homies die, the rest of them doing time, man. Do anybody care that I'm stressed?
I'm going
I don't come around, so I guess it's out of sight, out of mind. But do anybody care that I'm stressed? Everybody got their hand out asking me for shit. But do anybody care that I'm stressed?
Niggas don't know what I'm going through,
man. Do anybody care?
Deeper than
sold, I was abused.
Damn.
In the stomach, I swallowed like a balloon.
I was fucked up.
Zipper on my stomach because they split my liver.
Days
go by where I don't sip my liquor.
Drinking.
Where I don't roll when I twist my swisher. Thought I was helping with the pain, but I'm just getting sicker. Alcoholism is a sickness.
How
many people gonna admit that they addicted?
Nobody.
I drink cause I'm stressed. I'm stressed cause I'm depressed. Depressed cause I'm just tired of this shit. They like, why you stressed? Boy, you blessed. They don't know about the nights when I can't even get rest.
I'm losing sleep.
Burning this kush while I pace. Crying in the mirror every time I look at my face.
I hate this shit.
If you only knew what it took, what it takes. You only care what I put in my safe. What do anybody care?
Ah, this song's a lot deeper than I thought, right? I thought it was just talk about being stressed. His money ain't right. Getting shot at. I'm like, yo, live by the sword, die by the sword, motherfucker, right? But no, it's a lot deeper. He's talking about, being depressed, right? Mental anxiety, right? Or actually having to talk with someone about your addictions and substance abuse issues. And, yo, it's real, man. There's a lot of people, unfortunately, in the hood that we got to check on, that we got to, you know, they need help. And a lot of people don't even understand the route to go or what they should do or think it's uncool. And we got to change how that is looked at by the world, right?
I'm stressed
too, homie.
Most of my homies died, the rest of them doing time. And do anybody care that I'm stressed?
I'm going
around, so I guess it's out of sight, out of mind. But do anybody care that I'm stressed?
Do niggas care?
Everybody got their hand out asking me for shit. But do anybody care that I'm stressed?
Niggas don't know what I'm going
do
through, man.
Do anybody care?
Do anybody care that I'm stressed?
Do you know what it feels like to be alone? When the world counts you out, then you start counting yourself out. You can't even look at yourself in a mirror.
Oh, is this Wallo?
Because everybody else sees you lost. They see you fall. They watch you. Everybody watch you. They walk by you. They want to help you get back up. You was all alone. You was in a dark place. But one day that spark kicked in you. And you said, you know what? You got that old feeling that when you was a winner, when you was winning, when everybody said they loved you, but you was still by yourself. You was by yourself them nights in the gym. You was by yourself them nights on the track. And you said, I'm gonna come back. And that's what you did. You came back. But it was that moment when the world said, I don't want to be around you. I don't know you. You're not popular. You're not a winner. I don't got time to be waiting for you to win again. You came alive. That was the motivation that pushed you to come back. And now you're back. Now you're back at 100. And everybody know your name again. But you know what? You're not bitter. You're not mad. You're back. You're back. You're back.
Come home to visit my city. These fuck niggas try to take me out the game. But it's nothing, though. You know what I'm saying? It's nothing, though. I'm still here. By the grace of God, I'm still breathing, nigga.
Yeah, National Suicide Prevention Lifeline. Help is available, man. If you're ever feeling like, you know, shit ain't working well for you and the only option is to off yourself, bro, just take a few minutes and at least speak to someone, right? This was a lot deeper than I thought. It kind of got a different perspective on Conway the Machine, too, because I was kind of putting him in a box, right? Put him in a category. I don't think I even created a playlist for him on YouTube, right? It's just Griselda, and it says /something/something, right? It's like that kind of random drop box. But I like that. This was definitely better than I thought. I like his flow. You know, it just, to me, could be a little different. It's not like the type of music I always listen to. But it's sick. It's for sure sick, and it's not whack at all. I'd love to check out a few tracks that got more wordplay or something a little bit more stimulating than there's just the, man, I'm the dude. I sell mad weight. I got mad money, mad bitches eating off my plate, right? It's like, I like that, but I want to hear something with more substance, too. Maybe he's just not the artist for that, right? And that's okay, right? Maybe I'm not his demographic, but really looking forward to seeing some new music from him. If you guys know of anything I might want to check out that shows more of his depth, man, let me know in the comment section what to check out. I'll gladly take a look at two or three songs to, you know, just get a different opinion about the cat.